Hey guys, this is Balu from Balu Prime and once again welcome you all back for an exciting tutorial. In this tutorial, let's see how we can create this rigid body simulation in Blender easily. So I hope you will find this tutorial useful, but before going to that, if you end up liking this video, please click on that like button to share this content, and if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing my channel and support me. So further without any ado, let's begin. So here you can see I'm using Blender 2.83 version. Nice. Now let's select this light and camera and delete them. Now select this cube and move it here just above to this plane. Okay, now come to this physics properties, click on this and apply rigid body. In type, let it be active. Mass I will change to 0.25 kg. Here you can check out different values here, so for time being I will be leaving this to 2.5. and in shape, select box. Nice. So now if we play this animation, you can see the cube is falling down. So in order to avoid that, we need to add a ground plane. For that, go to this add mesh, select plane. Now press S on the keyboard and increase the scaling of this plane here like this. Okay, now select the plane and apply rigid body, but in type change that to passive. So if we play this, we can see that cube is not falling down. Okay, so now come to this world properties, color options, environment texture, and click on this folder and apply HDRI image. So you can find out HDRI images on HDRI Heaven. Download the HDRI image whichever you like and apply it here. Okay, so if I move to this render view, we can see that we got our environment map here. Okay, now let's apply some materials onto this plane and cube. So first select the plane, material, add new material, and let me change this to diffuse. Now come to this shading options, click on the shading. We got here our shading nodes, so let me place this here. Now click on this add button, input add texture coordinate, place it here. Now add vector and select mapping, place it here. Add texture and select image. Okay, now connect UV of this texture coordinate to vector of image texture, and color to color of the diffuse. Now here we can select any texture that we want to apply on this plane. So I will be applying this texture, let me see. Or else, okay, so we got this plywood texture onto this plane. So now let's apply texture onto this cube. Okay, so for that, again click on this material properties, delete this material. Now click on this drop down box and select material one. Now click on this number here, and now we can change the texture what we want. So here I will be selecting this, and we got our texture onto this cube also. Nice. Now come to this layout once again. Fine. Now let me move to this viewport shading. Now being selected this cube, click on this modifier properties, add modifier and add array. So in x-axis, change this to 1.1 and increase the count to 10. So here we got 10 cubes here. Now click on this copy button, scroll down, change this x value to 0 and increase this y value to 1.1. Okay. Now again, copy, scroll down, change this y value to 0 and z value to 1.1. So here you can see we got this stack of cubes here. So let me place it at the center like this. Okay. So these bunch of cubes are grouped together. So we want to separate them. So for that, first we need to apply all these modifiers. So click on this apply button and apply modifiers. After that, press tab on the keyboard to enter edit mode. Press A to select everything, and now press P and select by loose parts. So now we got cubes separated here. Now press Tab once again to exit edit mode. Now click on this object, set origin, origin to geometry. So each and every cube has its own vertex now. So we can select every cube and we can separate them if you want. Nice. So if we play this animation now, we can see that all cubes are getting settled here at 45th frame. Nice. Now let's create a sphere. So come to this add mesh, select UV sphere. Now let me place it above here like this. I think it is not centered. Let us move this sphere only here, and let us move this plane here like this. Okay. So select the sphere, press S and increase the scaling to your wish. Okay, I think this would be fine. Now right click and apply shade smooth. Okay, fine. Now come to this physics properties, apply rigid body. Wait, select sphere, come to physics properties and apply rigid body and type change to active, and mass I will be increasing this to 50 kg. Just try out different weights here, for example 70 100, like this, to get different kind of simulations. So I will be leaving this to 50. Shape, select this sphere here. Okay, so once this is done, now let's see the animation. So click on this play button. So here you can see that the sphere is crashing all the cubes here. Nice. So for example, if I increase the mass to 200, now let's check this how it will be. Let me play this. So I think you are seeing the difference when we change this mass value. Okay, so now come to this render view and let me see how it appears. Okay, so we need to apply materials to our cube also. So select, let me go to this first. Now select this sphere, come to this material options, add new material, and or else let us delete this and add this material only. Click on this number, come to the shading portion and let's select metal texture. So I think okay, so I got this metal texture onto the ball. Now let's bake this animation first. So for that, select this sphere, click on the scene properties, expand this rigid body world, scroll down to cache, expand that. Here I will be leaving the simulation start and end to 1 to 250 and just click on bake. So our baking is started here. So once the baking is done, now let's add camera into this scene. Further go to this add and select camera. Now press Ctrl Alt 0, come to this view properties here and lock camera to view. Okay, so now we can set our camera angle here. So once the camera angle is set, now let's move to this render properties. Here in render engine, we can use either EV or cycles. EV is fast, but cycles will be good. So let me show you. So if I select cycles, we can see the look of our image changes completely. But this cycles render will take much time when compared to EV. So if you are using cycles and your device supports GPU, so make sure that to select GPU compute here and also come to this layer properties, scroll down and enable this denoising option if you are using cycles render. So for this tutorial, I will be using EV. So I will be changing this to EV. So if you are using EV, enable ambient occlusion here. Okay, so here I will increase this distance to 0.4, that would be fine. Bloom, I think this is not required for this. Okay, so depth of field, if you want to add depth of field, we can do that. So in order to add depth of field, first we need to select our camera, come to this camera properties, and we need to increase this focal length. So let me increase this focal length to 85 And now let me adjust this once again. Okay, so I think okay, so let it be here. Now come to this depth of field, enable depth of field here, expand these options. So now in this focus on object, we can select the object which we want to focus. So for example, if I want to focus this cube, means select that cube, we got that cube here. Now in aperture, if we reduce this value like 0.5, okay, let me come to this, so let me reduce this to 0.1. So here you can see that depth of field is applied here, but our cube is in focus. So to render view, okay, so still if we reduce this to 0.05, we can see this depth of field is acting in the scene. So I'll be leaving this here. So once this is set, now let's move to render output properties. So for that, come to this output properties, click on that. Here you can set the resolution. Currently it is in full HD. I will be leaving to that. And also here you can set how many frames you want to render. So here starting frame is 1 and ending frame is 250, total 250 frames. And frame rate, here you can set frame rate what you want to have. So I will be leaving this to 24. Scroll down here, you can set the output folder. We need to select the output folder. So let me select that. So once the output folder is selected, uncheck this overwrite option. And file format, you can use either PNG or JPEG. Here I will be leaving this to PNG. So once this is done, now let's render this animation. So for that, come to this render and click on this render animation. So here you can say our render is started. So in this way we can create this rigid body simulation in Blender easily. So I hope you guys have learned something new from this tutorial. If you have learned anything new, please like, share and subscribe my channel and support me. So we will meet in the next video. Until then, signing off, take care, bye.